Hello everyone, welcome to St Nicholas Church in Codsall. It's lovely to see you all at today's Get Crafty at St Nick's. Oh, you've just caught me. I've just hurt myself. I caught myself on a pair of scissors. It was a silly thing to do and I've hurt my finger. And just before I start bleeding everywhere, I found a plaster. It's a good job, isn't it? I don't know whether you feel it. It hurts a lot. There are lots of times, isn't there, when we're hurting and when we hope a plaster will be enough to make it better. But sometimes we get really badly hurt and we need a bit more care and attention. Well, today's Bible story is all about someone who got badly hurt. And someone offered them all they needed to make themselves well again. So today's Bible story is all about the Good Samaritan. So the story of the Good Samaritan. There was once a man who was on his way to the temple, and he'd been travelling along a dangerous and dusty road, when suddenly some robbers appeared and they attacked him and they took his money and they ran away, leaving him battered and bruised on the road. After a while, a man appeared, could see how badly he'd been beaten and bruised, but thought to himself, I'm not stopping and waiting and helping, because what if those thieves or robbers are hidden behind a rock or a tree? They may come out and attack me next. Oh, no, I'm not going to stop here. So he walked quickly past. A little while later, another man came who was a priest going to the temple. He was in his best outfit. And as he walked along the road, he saw the beaten and bruised man on the ground. But he looked at the dust on the man, and he looked at his outfit, and he said, oh, no, I can't help. This will mess up my outfit. I will get all dusty too, and then I won't be able to help at the temple. I'm sorry, I'm not able to help. And so he closed his eyes as he walked quickly past. Well, the long time happened, and eventually he saw another person walking towards him with a donkey behind. And as he got closer, he realised that the man walking towards him was a Samaritan. Now, the Samaritans and the Jewish people, they didn't like one another very much. And so, lying on the ground, he thought to himself, well, the other two didn't help me. My enemy definitely isn't going to help me. And so he gave up. But as the Samaritan got closer, he stopped. He could see that the man was beaten and bruised, and he picked him up and put him on the back of his donkey. They went a little further along the dusty road before they got to a hotel, where the Samaritan could make sure that the battered and bruised man had a bed for the night, had some clean clothes and some food and some drink. And you know, the Samaritan even said, if taking care of him costs any more, then let me know, and the next time I come, I'll pay for it. Isn't it interesting that sometimes the most surprising people can help us, people we wouldn't imagine? Jesus reminded the people listening to him that it's important that we love our neighbours as we love ourselves. And sometimes that means loving people that we may not really get on with, but maybe we will learn something new about them, something that will be a surprise and make them look very different to us in the days to come. So now we move from the story to our craft. So today's craft. I thought I'd think about the donkey in the story, because that donkey plays a really important role, you know. He takes the battered and bruised man and he carries him until he's at a place where he can be cared for. So maybe you could go on the internet or just have somebody to draw it for you, but I've drawn a kind of donkey's body. You'll notice this donkey hasn't got any legs. And then you can colour that in or decorate it in whatever way you want to, especially the donkey's saddle. And then you cut it out. And on the donkey's saddle, I have written, "Love your neighbour as you love yourself." Well, it's a donkey without legs, so it's not going to carry anybody very far, is it? So I've got some pegs and we're just going to peg them onto the bottom of the body. And there we have our legs, ready to stand up. So I hope you've enjoyed today's craft. Let's end, as we always do, by saying a prayer together. So we'll take our two hands, and in this hand, it may well be that you can think of someone who needs a little help. Maybe it's even you. Maybe it's someone close to you, like a member of your family or a friend, just needs a little help. And in this hand, we ask God if they can have the right people come alongside them and help them. I can remember when I tried to learn knitting and I sat next to my mum. She taught me how to knit. And there's lots of people out there that can help us by sitting alongside us when we most need them to help us with something. So we'll put our hands together and let us pray. Heavenly Father, we pray for all of those people that need help today. We ask that you will be with them and that people around them will help them in so many different ways. And we thank you for those who surprise us and help us in ways that we couldn't imagine. Thank you for the blessing they are. Amen. And we blow those prayers up to God and leave God to handle them. He can sort them out better than we can. So it's been lovely sharing today's craft with you. I hope you've enjoyed it. I look forward to seeing pictures of your donkey on our Facebook page. Lovely to spend some time with you. Take care. Bye.